Hey everyone, welcome to the channel Green Learner. So it's pretty long time since I uploaded the last video. Earlier it was not supposed to be this much gap. Earlier I was like there was some function at home and I was supposed to take break of 1 month only, but things started happening one by one and this took so much long. Probably that scenario I'll cover in some other video. Just for this one, it's part of the playlist, so stick to the topic. So we're covering microservices demo series. Under this I have explained the architecture of online shopping portal where we are. So if we are on the same page, if you are following along from the starting one, you see this architecture. Like, so it's it doesn't look like any like software architecture, I think, as of now, if I think about it. So it's API gateway, but components are the same in PPT, in actual software. I'll redesign this one probably in some other video, how it is going to look like, probably end of the series. But this is something that we are going to build. So all these microservices that you are seeing, product, user management, cart, fraud check, notification, these are part of this series. And this product microservices I already have created. All the videos are on the channel and this part of this playlist. So subsequently, we are going to create all other one. And if you remember the last video, we talked about the user management, this user auth service. The user auth service I explained like this, like it is going to be have a user auth service. I explained it in that way, that it is going to have this user management and token generation, like login and all those things. It is going to take care of both of these things. But after this much long time, and there are many new things that have come to picture, or I have learned new things. So this, if you think about user registration and usual validations that happens, like you are entering username, password, and validation is happening. A normal token is being generated and it is being saved and it is valid for 10-15 minutes as per the use case. So if you think about this, user registration is kind of static. I can't say that it is static, but it is updated less frequently as per the validation things, that token generation, token verification, and all those things happening. So the database that is part of the user verification, user registration and token, it should be different, right? So with auth services, authentication services, we can use Redis, because that is kind of key value storage that we can have, and that session information and all those things that are there, that are like for particular time of they're valid, they are like significant for particular moment of time only. So that is why I have thought to separate this user auth service into two services like this one. So you see, we have user auth service that I explained. So I am going to divide it into user service and auth service. User service is going to have the endpoints that are only related to the user creation, like this one. Like user creation, like create the user, update the users, and delete if needed. When user is created, ask it to update the profile. Profile is going to have more details about the user, and then the password management. Like password verification, it wants to change that password, and storage validation and all those things is going to be taken care into this one. So when we have this user service created, then we can go ahead and create the auth service, which with the help of user service, where all the user details will be stored, it is going to validate the user, create the token, store the token, and do the all the things that are there. Okay, so in this video I'm going to focus on this one, user service. So let's see that one. Yeah, so component diagram. So it is going to more look like the architecture thing. So it is going to be the interesting part. So in component diagram, what I'm going to show you, that what all the things, what all classes, what all layers are microservices is going to have, all those things I'm going to explain in the component diagram. It is going to help us to create the mind map of the entire microservice that is there. And it is going to help us in the discussion also, that in the team, if we want to discuss with some other, we can take reference of this diagram and come up with new information, change this diagram as needed. So this is going to be like a very good point. Like I really feel about this one, that this is very interesting one, component diagram. Let me show you that. So here it is. So if you see, this is what it is look like. Like some of the texts are not visible, but see the high level, how it is like here is the client, here is the com.gl user service, this is our microservice, and this is the MySQL database. So let me zoom it a bit. Come here, clients. And here in this package, now focus on this one. So we have this com.gl.user service. This package, this is the microservice. Usually they have, if you focus on this this part here, a microservices have different thing, right? So first one is the controller layer, then we have services, then we have repositories. These things are there. So in this user service, I am going to have three controllers. So I'll explain that one, but first, so the first use case, consider about creating the user into the system. So the call flow is going to be like this one. Clients is going to call the user controller that you are seeing here. So the job of the controller is to delegate that call to the respective service, that user service, and user service is going to perform the business logic, and subsequently it is going to contact the user repository, which is going to take care of pushing the details into the database. And here for the database, what we have here we have MySQL database. In the MySQL we have this user service here. Okay, so this is going to take care of this entire flow that you are seeing here. It is going to take care of that user creation part. So in microservices, the most important thing is that how quickly we can create a sample sample piece which is able which we are able to see to the interested parties, and we can demo that in a single line. If I say minimum piece that we can create so that I can demo it. So here we can create this line here: clients, user controller, user service, repository, and in the database users. So we can create user service and focus on this dark gray color that we have focused. So initially we create this one, demo this one, and if things go fine, then we can proceed ahead and start adding the new feature here. Because you, in most of the companies nowadays, we have agile model, we have a sprints of 2 weeks, so we need to be able to complete like a working model, something like that in that time. So that is what it separates us. Like user controller is going to take care of the creating the user, probably that we can complete, and in a like 2 weeks of a sprint with couple of team members, that we can complete. In subsequent sprint, when user and what information we are going to capture in the user controller. If you imagine about the Amazon or Flipkart sign up page, they have information like enter the name, email or mobile, and password, and submit, and the profile is created, and user is created actually. And subsequently you can go to the profile page and update other informations there, like you can update the emails, you can add the address and all sort of information, payment information and all those things, you can update that one. So that thing, that other thing that I'm talking about, the profile controller here. So profile controller is this line here: profile, service, repository, profile and address. This line is going to take care of this one. And when this is completed here, the next thing comes. So in the user controller part, we ask the user to enter the email and mobile number also, right? So we need to verify that one. So we can generate a token like a OTP kind of thing and send the user to mobile and email and verify. We need to verify that when user enters that. So those verification part are going to taken care by this one: verification, service, repository, and user status and verification. This line, this is going to take care of that one. So you see, we have microservices which is going to take care of the user registration, and within the user registration service we have different responsibilities: user controller, profile controller, and user verification controller. And different team members can take the job, can take the responsibility of creating each flow separately. It is not going to create any conflict short of that one, right? So I hope this mind map is clear how our service is going to look like. And in the MySQL, now we have this table: profile, verification, user status and address. All these tables are here. As per the need, we can add more into this one. But for the discussion, it is good one that we can start with one. So what next? We have this high level diagram of this one, that this is how. But what about the use cases, real time use case, that user is coming, it is asking for the create user, and in some other flow it is going to update the flow, and in some other flow it is going to delete that user, and subsequently the same is apply user profile and user verification. And what really I'm talking about, the endpoints. Endpoints are specific to the use cases, right? So that, when we talk about that one, that comes into the sequence and use case diagram. That help us a lot here. So I have created one. When user is coming to sign up, we are going to register the user from the system. So how we can do that? Let me show you that. So for that, we have this sequence diagram. So yeah, here it is. So if you see this, we have user controller, we have user service repository, all these things created in MySQL. And this is the client here. It is sending the request here, arrow you can see, create user request, and what endpoint it is calling, and what request body it has. All information in the request body, all the user information is going to be there, like name, email or mobile, or both the things, or password. These minimum information that I am to ask for from the user. When the client has called with that information, the user controller is going to delegate that request to the user service. User service is going to perform the business logic around that information that client had sent, the user request body, the name, any sort of validation, like if the user has sent the password, right? And we cannot store that password in plain text in MySQL in any database. We need to convert that into the hash, because password storage is itself like complex mechanism, like we cannot store it in a plain text. So we have to convert that in hash code, some sort of secure hashing algorithm, using some sort of secure hashing algorithm, and then store that. So that logic is going to be there in the user service. And when we have all the user related data ready to be updated, ready to be added into the MySQL database, then we can pass that information to the user repository, and user repository is going to call the pass that information to the MySQL, and it can save, and accordingly as per the scenario it is going to return the pass or fail response. We hope that it will be passed, the data will be saved in the MySQL database properly. And when it is saved, user service is going to get that data here. And again, when we have all the user information stored in the database, and we need to pass some sort of response to the client also. So what information we need to pass to the user, that logic is also going to be in the user service. So those things we are going to perform here again in this one. When that is ready, we are going to pass that information to the client, to the controller, and subsequently it is going to be passed to the client. And now our user is created into the system with basic information. Next, what can happen? User entered mobile and email, and in this validation logic here also I created a sort of some token also to validate that mobile number and email also, and send the link. And then in the front end system we can ask the user to verify those details, right? When verification happens, then the next flow comes into picture. So if you see this diagram, now verification controller part is in picture here. So that sequence diagram I have not created here, but you got the idea that how to create this one, right? So how to get this flow ready. Verification controller is done, then profile controller is going to be the same way. Probably in couple of next video I'm going to create couple of more sequence diagram like this one, which is going to help us. But I highly suggest you to create this your own. If you got the understanding of this one, if you have any confusion how to create this and all those things, put that in comment section. I'll be happy to reply that and help you in this one. So how have I created this one? I'm going to put the link of that one, like it's a Plant UML unified modeling language that I have used. That link, it is very easy to follow. I'll put the link in the description box. You can go ahead and see that directly. Otherwise, in the next videos and subsequent videos, I'm going to create some of these sequence diagram and component diagram hands-on in videos also, and that can help you to more get into this architecture. So sequence diagram is done. So what next that I'm going to cover here? So architecture mind map use cases ready here. So next is code walkthrough. So I have all the endpoints of the respective things, user controller profile and verification things ready. So I'll walk through the code in the next video. And one more thing also, the microservices is not all about the business code only. It is all about the other things like side things like logging, monitoring, documentation, these things. So I'm going to integrate all these things in this user service also, along with the testing, integration testing, all those things. That is going to come in the subsequent videos. So I hope it was helpful. It can help you. So sequence diagram and component diagram is the new addition in the series. I hope it was helpful. Let me know your thoughts in the comment section. So the last thing before ending the video, I wanted to say that this video series I wanted to start from pretty long time, but couldn't start this one due to some reasons. But it's better late than never, right? So I feel happy. I feel good about it that I started this one. Like today is 31st December, end of year 2021, and. I started this one, and let's hope that in 2022 it's not going to be this much long gap, and I'm going to come up with more regular videos. And first thing that I'm going to do is complete this series, because it contains very, very useful informations about the microservices architecture that we do in our day-to-day life, and it is like important ingredients in microservices. And you can say it's not hello world kind of thing. It's more on the real time thing that we do on the microservices. If you are seeing the auth service, it is going to contain all the important components related to that one, right? So I'm hoping to complete this one as soon as possible, and there are many things that I have that are in my mind that I'm going to upload on the channel that is going to help you a lot in your career and interviews and all those things. With that, let's end this. I'll see you in the next video with the code walkthrough. Till then, take care, stay safe, bye-bye.